Welcome guys to another video this week, so yeah, let's get started. Woke up and just felt right, phone blown like a tailpipe. Today's schedule airtight, it's on a short day into a long night. See you soon if you got the heart. So currently we are still in the Eastern event, and I really enjoy the event. It gives a lot of gold. The drops are insanely way better than last year. Last year we had to run arena to get many red eggs, and this time you can get, I don't know, maybe 15, sometimes 15 red eggs in one run. Anyways, that's not the way we are, the point of the video. The point of the video is showing you guys which one is the best build for the event. As a mage, because rogue and warrior, it's not my class, so neither I like them. Mages, they are cute anyways. So yes, there are a couple of builds. Let's get started with fireball. I prefer fireball because it's actually a skill which reloads really quickly and does a lot of damage on easy targets like KT4 mobs and mobs of the event. Also, it has damage which applies over seconds, so over time damage. And not only fireball, before fireball we put all our points into intelligence, because it's our main class, and you need, for event, you need to get as much damage as possible in health. Doesn't really matter, neither does armor. Critical can matter, because the more you crit, the more damage you deal. And yeah, that's basically it. Speed can only be useful to Archetomes or Krakentomes. Anyways, also I'd like to use Gale, because also it attacks multiple mobs and does not much damage, but it does many things at the same time. Also I'd like to use Gale because multiple mobs, and it's not a skill which reloads quickly, but it also adds armor. The armor can be used for protection, as you guys already know. For Gale, I'd like to attach the first upgrade besides the dash from the one which dashes you forward. You can use the one which dashes you forward unless you have speed set. If you speed set, it's really annoying to use it, because otherwise you can't chain armor without pushing yourself. Anyway, and yeah. So if you have speed set, please don't use it, and it's not necessary at all. Then lightning. I'd like to use lightning because it's a really effective skill, with the one which deals the highest damage. Also have three upgrades, not the last one, because the last one applies stun, and stun, it's not what we need in PvP, PvE. Only in PvP, in versus builds, for example, then it's really good to use a stun. Also, one skill, the ice skill. I rarely use ice because it's not my favorite skill, and yeah, I really don't like it. But and for Evans, it's really good. It's like lightning. It adds a lot of damage, and it reloads really, really, really quickly, as same as lightning. Just the damage is a bit less, but it can also freeze mobs, bosses. It depends of you if you use the mastery or not. At least, clock. It's basically not for the event zone itself, but just to run watch toms for and kraken toms and those kind of maybe haunt itself and maybe haunt not even. Those kind of things. It's really, really, really useful. Yeah, that's actually it. Then we go to the passives. For passives, we use, as always, Mind Knowledge and the Guilty. It's basic upgrades. Everyone uses it, I hope. Otherwise, I don't know what kind of bot you're using, but would be really, really special if you don't use it. Then we go to see Masteries. Masteries, I prefer to use Gale 10-10, so there, all the negative things will be removed and you won't get stunned nor anything. If you don't use, for example, this event, you need a rabbit food to get not stunned, but if you use the Gale, then it's also fine, I think. Even with combined with shield and necro AA, it's decent. No, I don't know actually if Gale... No, Gale can't resist a stun of the bunny in this event. Anyways, doesn't matter, it can remove curse and that's it. So we have the four skills: Fireball, Gale, Lightning, Frostbolt and Clock. So we have 10-10 in Gale, and then we add 5 or 6 in Clock, because the banish is really useful against stronger mobs. If you only run Kraken Tombs, it's not really necessary. But and then 5-10 into Fireball. Fireball, it makes it also reload more quicker, and that's better. And in general, it's better, and it applies other things, special things, and yeah, it's really really good. So that's kind of my build. Well, besides those two more passives which we need. We add armor and also another 5 into damage. Crit, it's not necessary, I think. Yeah, you can use it, but it's not a must. And speed, yeah, it's not cap 41 anymore. Well, that's my build, and I hope I could help you with it. So let's see, we were about to get platinum. And I think this is my last run, which I needed to reach platinum tier. So let's open those eggs and see what we get. So thanks for watching and enjoy the rest of the video. See you guys later.